All right, gang, let's really nail it this time. Here we go.
A one, a two, a one, two, three, four.
The worst thing I've ever heard. This is $1,200 a week for voice lessons, and this is what I get? Okay, I'm going to save it with the solo.
Bow, bow, I'm Derek, and I can sing high like this. And I can sing high.
Jesus!
We asked you on Instagram to ask us questions, whether it be couple questions or questions just individual. And I took the time to go through every single question, you guys. I did read every single question. And I wrote down a pretty good amount. And I tried to choose ones that we don't normally answer, because I know when I do Q&As, I get a lot of questions that are similar or the same. So I'm also going to be calling out your name. I did write your guys' usernames down. If I pronounce anybody wrong, I'm terribly sorry. It's gonna happen, because, you know, sometimes you just don't know how to pronounce things. So let's begin. So we're gonna start off with a little juicy question from Mia98. How does Becky feel about you still hanging out with your ex sometimes?
Well, Destiny, I really like Destiny. She's really cool. We have a lot of fun together. Me and her can joke around, and, you know, we like Dana too, so there's nothing really bad to say about it.
Dora3305 asked, do you have any contact with your family? So, I'm assuming, we talk a lot about Becky's family, very close-knit family. Medic Femme 19 said, may I be your sister wife?
Once I throw on this bout, you go wow wow, what you gonna say? You act like you gon' mean, but I know that you gon' fade. Break it down, dig it down, down.
You wanna have sex?
No, 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 no.
Like I said, bad at pronouncing. It's A-M-C-H-E. Said, is Becky ever going to make her own channel?
I don't know. Maybe someday in the future. But right now, I'm happy just being a part of, you know, my girlfriend's channel.
Oh, baby.
Kylie Wren, what was the last argument you had?
It was at this moment he knew. He fucked up.
Don't write on me.
So, I think it's Becky sometimes randomly wakes up and wants to clean the whole house.
Shucks, folks, I'm speechless.
Like, literally top to bottom, which I'm fine with. But her persona changes. She becomes, I don't even know what, like the parent you didn't want.
You're not the boss of me now. You're not the boss of me now. You're not the boss of me now. And you're not so big.
Like, your whole persona completely changes. So when I woke up and she was acting all parental, I'm just like, honey, no, no. Like,
you're not the boss of me now.
That was about an hour ago.
I just said, will you help me sweep a room?
It's just, we're never in the mood to clean at the same time. Like, nobody, even Eric and Ricky, like,
maybe
none of us.
You can edit this out, but you're never in the mood to clean.
I'm not editing that out, because it's true.
You're never in the mood to clean. I need you to get a little bit in the mood to clean.
I like cleaning is when I'm like super mad about something, because it's so therapeutic. Katie Early asked, what movie title best describes your life?
Oh god. There's so many movie titles. So how do you work that into your life? I'll tell you, my favorite movie is Anchorman, but my life is nothing like Ron Burgundy's.
I'm very important. I have many leather-bound books, and my apartment smells of rich mahogany.
People seem to like me because I am polite and I'm rarely late. I like to eat ice cream, and I really enjoy a nice pair of slacks. Years later, a doctor will tell me that I have an IQ of 48.
No, we're just going with the title. We're not talking about the actual movie.
I can't think of one.
Me neither.
Donnie Darko. I see this giant rabbit that I talk to.
And baby, it's not end. About... Oh my god, it's about the title! Like, if we were going with a show, it'd be like The L Word or 600 Pound Life.
We are not that cool.
Hey, doctor.
Hello. How y'all doing?
Okay, how are you doing?
All right. So as you know, you just weighed 750 pounds. That's a weight gain of 112 pounds in 1 month. And the leg are more infected than before. And infection is building up and getting bloodstream. We're going to have a serious problem.
Sorry, my lymphedema was in the way.
Lammer Barbecue asked, do you like Fifth Harmony? I like some of their songs.
I listen to a lot of different things, but that's just not my thing.
XO Wonderlust TTXO asked, has Becky ever had any paranormal experiences? She has, and I think we should talk about those in like a different video. Yeah, because we don't want to make this too long, but I think in like a vlog you should do like a little mini like
we have
Becky
plans.
Story time.
No! Yeah, I want to talk about my Christian school days. I want to talk about my paranormal experiences.
Her coming out story is pretty great.
I do want to do my coming out story. It's just we need to literally schedule what days we're going to do that on and just literally do it.
People
walking.
Hi, people. Rebecca HHDS1 asked, does Amberlynn's weight ever bother Becky?
No. I tend to walk faster, so she kind of gets left behind sometimes.
And here we are again. 47-yard try. His longest attempt of the game. He has missed his last two.
So I have to stop, slow down, and then she catches up.
Unless I got tennis shoes on.
Yeah.
That's a lie. Gamer.o asks, what's your favorite Disney movie?
Pocahontas. Have you ever heard the wolf cry to the blue corn moon? Or asked the grinning bobcat why he grinned? Can you sing with all the voices of the mountain? Can you paint with all the colors of the wind? Can you paint with all the colors of the wind? Come run the hidden pine trails of the forest. Come taste the sun-sweet berries of the earth. Come roll in all the riches all around you. And for once, never wonder what there was. If I could be anywhere right now, I'd probably lay in a field of sunflowers and just look up at the sky and ask why. Why me? That was really fast. Yes, it was.
I'm gonna go with Alice in Wonderland. Nicole K. Hollil, F1. Oh, that's a 5, not an F, excuse me. 5-1.
What?
Has Greg tried apologizing to you guys?
No. Nope. And I don't care if she does or not. I'm not talking to her.
I'm kind of back and forth, and that's just me being honest.
Yeah, because you're like super forgiving, and I also am very super forgiving, but it's been too many times. Y'all don't know about all them other times, but it's been too many times.
I think I may have called her Hamberlin once.
Morgie Bait. That doesn't say
Morgie. Wait, hold on. I just want to touch on that. Just one more time. I forgive her in my heart, but I don't think I could ever be friends with her again. As bad as that still does hurt. Cause baby, now we got bad blood. You know it used to be mad love. So take a look what you've
done. Cause baby, now we got bad blood. Hey! Morgie Baby 14 asked, does Becky ever cook for you? So when we're eating healthy, I don't want her to cook for me. I'm very picky. Picky probably isn't the right word. I'm very just, I need to know what's in my food when I am eating healthy and trying to have a healthier lifestyle.
I'm not trying to be rude. I'm a more picky person.
No, I'm not talking about food-wise. Right. And she's not even that picky. She acts like she is.
And here we are again. 47.
It's I like true, broccoli, baby. And I baby, absolutely hated that broccoli slaw you put in something. And I'm just like, I like broccoli, that is disgusting.
And that's why I'm never gonna cook it again.
Yeah, that was gross. Look here, Miss Thang, hate to salt your game, but you's a money younger woman and you need to change. In the locker room, all the homies do is laugh. High fives, cause another nigga played your ass. It was said you were seasoned, even easy, sleeping around for what you need. So it's your thing and you can shake it out. Becky was raised to cook unhealthy. I'm just saying.
No, we weren't.
Like, she's not very good at cooking healthy, and I'm not saying I'm Gordon Ramsay at healthy cooking. I'm not.
He's the best.
And there's the fillet. Look at the fillet! Hey! The chicken's raw! Donkey!
No.
I've done the whole healthy cooking so much that I'm very, like, used to the healthy cooking, and again, I'm not the greatest. But I just like to know what's in my food. If we're ever eating unhealthy and she wants to make some spaghetti, like, sure.
I'm so good at making spaghetti.
Things like that. So, no, I do the cooking around here. And I just hope that she will do the dishes afterwards. So it's...
And I always do.
Half and half. Hope Doesn't Float said, do you believe in God or a higher power?
Yes.
I'm agnostic. I'm not going to really go into details about that.
Even though somebody was arguing with you, that means you're atheist. No.
No, I'm not agnostic.
Read your facts, buddy.
I'm just agnostic. Do you know what I have? I had an accent. That was weird. Vanessa Fabre asked, what happened to looking for a place of your own? So, my initial thing was I was moving here because I was having a hard time finding a place for all of my animals. I was wanting to be near Becky because we were hours apart. I was hours apart from anybody who remotely even cared about me in the slightest. And I was very secluded, and I felt like I was in a cage. I was literally trapped. I was very uncomfortable. I was felt unsafe.
Very alone with just a few animals.
Help me! Help me!
In the arms of the angel, fly away from here.
Yeah, I mean, my animals are everything to me.
Well, yeah, so. I love your animals too, but it's just, they don't talk back. And if someone barks into your house, the most they're going to do is want to be pet on.
That's a lie. Would kick your fucking
Twinkie
ass.
Will bark. She gonna bite.
Her claws are perfect. See, the thing is, when a stranger comes in here, Twinkie goes crazy. And she doesn't bite. That's true. She doesn't bite. But I feel like if she knows I was like in danger or something, then she would probably bite. Like, cause you know, if she notices her mom, if she smells fear on me and the situation seems rough, then you know.
I don't know.
But
Maybe I am biased because she never acted like that, even meeting me for the first time. All she did was bark
no,
a little bit.
No, because she could
I
feel
sat on the floor
she could
right
feel that I loved you.
Right.
Like, I'm not trying to be mean because me and Dana are, like, on it. Like, me and her are friends now.
Oh, my God. I love your bracelet. Where did you get it?
But obviously, at first, it was weird. Twinkie wouldn't even go near Dana. Like, at all. And Twinkie stopped going near Destiny. You didn't even ask Destiny for a long time because she feels how I feel.
Mr. Steel Girl is bad.
Yeah, Twinkie Dish went right up to them last night. They were over here last night.
Yeah, because everything is fine now.
Yeah.
So. Anyways, that's like a whole other thing. So when I moved here, I was not supposed to have my cats, but you guys know the whole story about that. Now I have all my pets and that makes me so beyond happy. So I have no reason to move in this very moment. I do catch myself looking for places to move to. And I always like show Becky randomly. I'm like, oh, look at this place. This place is cute. Because I don't want to have a roommate situation my whole life.
Well,
I'm
no.
27 years old and it's fun.
Like, it's honestly super fun, super fun, super fun.
To be living with not only your girlfriend, but you're living with friends. Every day, it feels like you're having like a slumber party in a way. Mm. Like, you're never bored. And I'm gonna be honest, even when you want time alone, you still don't get that time alone. So it's kind of like you just always have someone there, which can, you know, be bittersweet. But I don't know. There will be a time when we do move, but it's not happening now because I have my animals. I have my girlfriend. I have my pets. I have my own room. I have my own bathroom. I have my own living room. I have my own space for things. And this place is a big house and it needs lots of loving, and I'm part of that loving, so.
And I'm saying, you know, even whenever we do decide to, you know, branch out and move in our own place one day, I'm still gonna very much want Eric and Ricky in my life. So.
What does that have to do with it, baby?
No, I'm just saying. They're
they're your family.
You guys are still gonna be seeing them.
Oh, yeah.
So don't worry about it. You know, one day whenever it does happen,
Becky's,
you'll still be seeing
Becky's them. Just afraid to leave them for.
Just like always, whatever you want.
Whatever I want. It's never whatever I want.
It's fine.
When I wanted to see Stomp and you wanted to see Wicked, what did we see?
We saw...
When I said that I wanted to have kids and you said that you wanted me to have a vasectomy, what did I do? And then, when you said that...
They're my best friends.
Yeah. Monica143 asks, who usually says sorry first? I believe it's me.
Bitch, what?
I feel like Becky.
Oh, hell no!
Doesn't say sorry.
There's been plenty of times I have said sorry.
I feel like you don't say sorry.
I do say sorry.
When?
There's been plenty of times that I have texted you or said I'm sorry, and then you calm down.
Maybe, but I feel like I say it, like physically say it.
You might physically say it, but I physically show it.
Like, it's weird. I can fume for a long time. I can be mad for a long time, no matter how much you say sorry. But then there's another part of me where I can just get over something so fast. I'm just like, I don't fucking care. It's weird. I can go both ways.
Especially if we're in the car and we argue about something, let's not talk. And it's usually me sliding my hand over onto her side. It's like,
my nose ring is itching my nose. So if you guys see me, yeah.
Can't believe you don't think I ever say sorry.
No, you do, but sometimes it's just me.
Sometimes it's just me.
Real relationship, y'all. Smegma Cereal asked, would you ever be a mortician? No.
No. I have this thing with touching dead things. I don't like to touch. I had a
bird fell off a tree one time and I tried to take care of it and it ended up dying anyway.
She passed away in 2015 at the age of 19. And she passed away in 2015. And no, wait, that was my great-grandmother. My mamma passed away in 2012, so it's been a while since we've had her cooking.
They have been used to try to kill a possum that was sneaking into the chicken coop.
And I didn't even want to touch it to get it out of the cage, so I just tipped the cage out and I'm like, that's, I know, that sounds awful. I just can't touch dead things.
Speaking of dead, Death Church asked, who are Becky's favorite bands?
I have so many, but I really like Brand New. Whitechapel, Pantera, Chelsea Grin. I like Sublime. That's when things got out of control. She didn't want to. He had his way. She said, let's go. He said, no way. Come on, babe, it's your lucky day. Shut your mouth, we're gonna do it my way. Come on, baby, don't be afraid. If it wasn't for day rape, I'd never get laid. I like very different bands, so.
She listens to a variety of stuff, and I've
Deftones.
I've never not liked anything that you've listened to.
Are you sure?
Oh, I'm sure.
I wrestled a bear once. I mean, they're...
Even she'll put on Screamo, and she expects me to, like, think some bad ways. I'm like, no.
I was playing Korn one time, and she was asleep in the car, and she wakes up, and she's like, this is good. I'm like, you like Korn? Oh, my God.
I never listened to Korn before, but, like, my music taste is very, very wide, and I just like my body. I'm excited for you, the haters. Just like my body. Tasty Oolong Tea asked, what are your ultimate goal weights? 199.
I would just be happy to get below 200. Or even down to, like, you know, 210. I don't care to be a little chunky.
Can you imagine us both weighing the same weight?
I don't want to be. Day? I will tell you this.
Can you imagine that?
No.
Me neither.
I can tell you this. I don't want to be a stick. I don't want to be
no, I don't like that.
Skinny.
I don't
and I will tell you why. Yeah, sometimes you can be healthy. Sometimes it's very unhealthy to be skinny. But I dated I had a girlfriend one time.
Baby,
she's passed away.
Don't say this. It's going to offend them.
Why?
What you're about to say.
I just did not like how much taller she was than me. She was really tall.
Baby, what? We're talking about her weight.
Yeah, no, okay. She was really skinny and really tall. So I had to look up, and whenever we would hug, it was like Listen. Which I don't know why she was with me, because, you know, I was not much smaller.
Than I am now. Beautiful, and you're cute, and your personality's on, and
Listen, I don't want to be skinny because skinny isn't always healthy. You know, people always assume just because you're skinny, it means you're healthy. No, don't work that way. I like
thick.
I like
chunky.
I just don't want to be morbidly obese. And right. I mean, even if I was morbidly obese, like a little bit, because 199 would still be considered morbidly obese, but it'd be a lot better than where I'm at now.
Oh my God, Becky, look at her butt. It is so big.
I don't see what's wrong with Trump shopping at Walmart. What's wrong with it?
6/16/12 asks, which one of your insecurities in the relationship? I think for me, this is going to sound really dumb, but I think for me is like, I can't compare to, oh God, how do I word this? I can't compare physically to other girls. I feel like she will look at me and be like, why am I with her? Like, she's fat. And I know she can get better and more attractive. And
same thing could be said of you.
What? Raritals.
Y'all might not believe this, but Amberlynn has a line of people that would like to be with her.
Oh my God.
And send her things.
I know, I block.
Like yesterday.
Ew.
Anyways, what's your biggest insecurity in the relationship?
Who, me?
I'm gonna be completely honest about it. People in my family have lost weight and left their significant others because they thought that they could do better. Ow, Rarity, you're already gorgeous. And people have said before, when she loses weight, she is gonna be banging. And it's true. Like, you are gonna be like, whenever you look the way you want to look, you're going to have confidence out of this world. And all I'd have to do is one thing wrong to piss you off. And you just be like, you know what? I'm too good for this. Bye.
Baby, come here. I love you.
I love you too.
Next question is from Kawaii Ninja Cat. When was the moment that you guys realized you loved each other? So,
I feel like we talked about this.
Me too, but I forget.
I remember.
It was like a census.
For me, it was just where I've been hurt so much and so deeply, I really blocked myself hardcore from Amberlynn. But I knew I wanted her in my life. That probably was a little selfish. But I was very distant, and sometimes I would be a little, you know, just like standoffish. But one day we got into a really bad fight about it, and it's just like a brick on the wall around my heart was pushed out, and just a little bit came out, and I was crying, and I'm just like, you know, maybe it is because I love you. And I was just like, and she's like, what? And I'm like, yeah, I love you. And we were in a fight, and I was just like, yeah, I love her. Love this girl. I can't deny it anymore, as much as it might hurt me in the end. But
you're gonna make me cry. ZZZ asks, or is that Talia 222? Either way. What's your favorite thing about each other and least favorite? So my favorite thing about Becky is her personality. I think she's super funny. Least favorite would be, sometimes she don't listen to me. I'm like talking and like,
I have a very bad habit of spacing out, and you guys have probably witnessed it in videos before. You're like, Becky doesn't look happy. No, that's me spacing out.
I do it too.
I just tend to get in a little rocket and travel off somewhere for a minute. I don't know why I do it. I just do. But I'll say my most favorite thing about Amberlynn is she knows how to make me laugh. And my least favorite thing about you is, used to be the jealousy, but it's not even really that anymore. It's Amberlynn.
Oh God.
I will say something or do something, and I don't intend it to be anyway. And she will take it completely wrong.
I mean, sure it was.
My feelings are hurt. You've hurt my feelings. How could you do that to me? How could you say that? Why did you do that? Why don't you love me?
I'm like,
what are you talking about?
That is my most quote. If we ever get married, in my vows, at the end will be, why don't you love me? Or do you not love me?
Yeah.
Like, I always say that. Like, I'm so, oh my God, I'm sorry. Okay. Last freaking question, y'all. Miss Samantha Perez, what do you guys see happening this year? Hopefully, for me, losing a good amount of weight.
Outlook not so good.
Me too.
Outlook not so good.
Honestly, to some people, this isn't going to be like a big thing, but I want to lose like 50 pounds this year. That I could lose a lot more, but it's like, for me to lose 50 pounds in 1 year, just that's a good chunk. And I think that's just really what I want to aim for.
Outlook not so good.
And if I do more than that, that'd excite me.
Yeah, me too.
You want to lose 50?
Well, I just want to lose some.
Yeah. So, is that it?
Yeah.
So, that's the end of our video. That's really long. I have a lot of editing.
Yeah, you do.
Hope you guys enjoyed.
Okay, bye.
Bye.